Okay.
So what questions, again, what would you like to go over? Mallory, stop it.
Can you go over that tension?
Okay, so let's go over a problem with tension. I'll try to write things pretty big up here. So, simple, medium, hard, your call.
Hard.
Okay, so... So let's say we have something like this, and I'm going to put, I'll do this. Theta's the angle here. Mass M. Mass 2M. Mu of 0.2. And nope. The initial is down the hill. So we're going to say that we're going to consider uphill as the positive direction. Okay. So in this particular case, would this thing falling downward be a positive or negative direction?
Negative.
How did you decide that?
You're talking about the regular M, right?
The 2M block, sorry.
Oh, falling down?
What is Brock going to see?
I mean, it would make sense for it to be negative, but it's kind of dependent upon like your reference there, because like
so what's
we're saying
reference?
Uphill, like uphill is like
uphill is the positive direction.
Are we including the theta there, like as? Oh, I'm trying to think of it like as like the force of it would be acting like at an angle.
It would be. We'll have to work through that a little bit later.
Okay.
But before we can decide whether to like adding or subtracting things, we've got to decide which direction we are considering positive for all things. This thing is pretty obvious because it's we're told that. In this case, which direction would it be?
I think up would be positive.
Okay. Why do you think that?
Because it's going in like the same direction as the M would be going if it was
positive. Is the what would be going?
As the regular M, like if the M is going uphill like this, then it's considered positive. So like if the two, wait,
no, hold on.
Because if the M
was,
would it be up as negative because if the
M is going down,
correct,
is going down, it's pulled.
Positive is the so if these things move together because they're connected, and this thing moves up, this one's got to move down.
Mm-hmm.
So if that's the positive direction, that's got to be the positive direction in our equations. So we have to look carefully at that. Sometimes it won't tell you what's a positive frame of reference. You could decide it, but you have to be careful and consistent throughout. So that's why I said this is difficult, because my initial velocity is in the negative direction. So in this case, I basically be asked to solve two things. One would be find acceleration, and the next one would be find tension. Actually, this one, the tension might be easier, to be honest with you, than the acceleration, so we'll find that. Where do you think we'd start to find acceleration?
Second law.
So I'm going to think something like this. A equals F net, M two. We're going to say this is massless pulley, because we haven't done rotational stuff. So let's think about what forces would be acting on it and masses would be acting with it to think about the acceleration.
Is it the acceleration of the system? Or?
Would you separate them into two separate systems, or do you think you would just be...
So let me ask this. Is this going to accelerate at the same rate or different rate than that?
Same
rate. So you got to be careful, because if I say, what's the acceleration of 2m, you still have to think of the whole system, because both of the these are affecting the acceleration.
Because you're going to think of them separate if they're not
connected.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay. So what's one force? What would we start off with? It might be a positive value.
Gravity.
Okay. Acting on what? Well, that's a problem because it's like, would gravity cause this thing to accelerate in a positive or negative direction?
Positive.
Will gravity cause this thing to accelerate in a positive or negative direction? So I'm going to have to handle gravity on this and gravity on this as two separate forces, which I can do. Okay. So which one do you want to handle first?
2m.
2m? Okay. So how would I find, in terms of variables, the force on this one? 2mg. That's the easiest one, I think. And that's going to cause it to go in a positive direction. So we've got 2mg. Actually, what I'm going to do this, I'm going to do that in the next step. So I'm going to say F grav on 2. Okay. What's another force affecting the acceleration of this system? F grav on 1. Okay. Adding or subtracting it?
Should be subtracting it. Should it be F grab on 2m, not 2kg?
2m, you're right. Thank you. And the thing is, gravity acts directly down. I'm probably not going to solve for gravity acting on this because gravity isn't really causing it. What is causing this thing to want to accelerate? Parallel component of gravity. Now you might be able to recognize that or not, but I want to make sure I wrote it down. So I'm going to say minus F parallels on M. Anything else on this? I almost tripped.
Friction.
Okay. So friction on what?
The M.
On M. Okay. Adding or subtracting?
Subtracting.
Why?
Loop.
Motion.
Oh, the initial motion is still left.
Correct. So it should be positive. So it's sneaky here. You're correct, and friction always opposes motion. Mm-hmm. According to the frame of reference we had, this is up. The block is initially moving down. So it's like someone had pushed this earlier and then let go. So in this case, I'm going to add the force of friction. The bottom, m plus 2m. So now I'm going to have to get math here. So I'm going to say, okay, I'll do the simple part first. That's easy. You said 2mg already for this. Well, in terms of variables, how do I find the force of friction? How do I get that?
Mu force normal.
Say it again?
Mu force normal.
Mu times force normal. And in this case, if I want to find F parallel, I'm going to have to do something with this also. So at this point, I'm going to break this up into parts. So I'm going to say that would be mg. That would be the normal component of mg. This would be the parallel component of mg, right? Okay. So, and that's going to be a similar angle to what we had. So up here, how could I figure out force normal from this triangle?
Mg cosine theta.
Adjacent side, it's going to be cosine theta. And this mg is always the hypotenuse. In these triangles, it's always the most. I shouldn't say always, but it's almost always. Okay. So I'm going to say mu mg cosine theta. Cool. So that's that. What would this be?
Mg sine theta.
Mg. I put this as 0.2, which is annoying. I should have just left it as mu, because everything else is a variable. So I'm going to going to say minus mg sine theta plus u mg cos theta over 3m. That's a lot of stuff, right?
Could you cancel out the m's?
I can!
Oh my god, you scared me.
Isn't that awesome? I love this. So in this particular case, I think we're kind of done. I could put 0.2 in for mu, right? So something like that. On an AP exam, because I didn't plan this particularly well because I was coming up with it when you asked about a problem, they probably would actually have a lot of other things either cancel out or combine. Like somehow you might end up with something like sine theta over cosine theta, which is tangent theta, or something like that. So I don't know how to simplify this more than this. I could factor out the g and put 2 minus sine theta plus mu cos theta. That doesn't do up on the top, but I can't do anything else with that. So there's not much more there. I guess I will do that just to, because it makes me feel better about myself. So sometimes things will cancel out even more than that. And they probably would in an AP problem, because then finding this is really difficult with that. But let's go through at least how we would find the tension. So how would you find the tension?
Yeah. You could use the F net, acceleration was F net over N to
second law.
You could do F net equals acceleration times mass total. We could change our system to just encompass the 2m and the rope.
I think that's the one to do, because that there's only the tension and gravity acting on it, right?
Yeah.
So I guess what I would say for that is this, because there's friction and it's on a hill, seems more complicated. A lot of times it doesn't matter much, but that's my new system. So now thinking about this new tension, I'm going to say F net equals M system times A. What would be my F net here?
Gravity.
Okay. On what? Gravity on what?
2m.
Okay, so it's basically
2mg.
2mg minus T. T is what I'm trying to solve for. This would equal 3m.
No, it would equal 2. Because it's
because it's not. Yes, thank you. 2m. And then times all this glop over here. Right? So because I couldn't simplify it, like I said, this is why this is not like a real AP problem perfectly, because you wouldn't have something that messy in there. But it would basically be times that. So then what you would do. Minus sine theta plus mu cos theta, and that is going to be O. Say it again. Did I screw it up?
No, you got it.
Okay. And then now I can add two, basically subtract 2mg from the other side.
That's
over
3.
Over 3. So negative T equals the. A mess. Hey, but you know what? I can cancel M's out again. Or not cancel them out, but. Yeah, this is way messier than it would be. Well, honestly, that's because this was pretty messy. Like I said, there's ways to cancel that out, but sometimes you might have something that complicated. Like, if you start with this, and you can, like, recognizing that that was positive and that was negative was probably the difficult conceptual piece. Recognizing how to handle this, it seemed like you did pretty well, I thought. So that was good. Recognizing this, like how you get the tension, also good. So this part would maybe be 1 point of maybe 10 points of a problem. Yeah.
I'm confused why it's 2mg minus t instead of t minus 2mg.
Okay. So thinking about that, what direction did we define as positive here? Okay. We said
going down.
Yeah, down is going to be positive, right? So because that, we think of this as a positive value. We don't know if it's positive, because actually it depends on that angle, right? Although I actually think it would be positive here, because I don't think it could add up that much. But essentially, we're thinking of this as a positive acceleration. So that means that this quantity here, we also want to be consistent with whatever this is. So if we said this acceleration is downward positive, then I want to think of the downward force here as positive, which is why it's 2mg minus t, as opposed to t minus 2mg. So if up was positive, Reagan, it would be t minus 2mg. Down is positive, it's 2mg minus t. And that equals mass times this acceleration, which we've already defined as downward. It doesn't look like you're happy about that.
I don't know.
So let's pretend this number is 5, because it's a mass. So let's pretend it's 5. Would that acceleration be 5 meters per second squared down, or would that acceleration be 5 meters per second squared up?
Down.
It would be, because we said down was positive, uphill was a positive direction, but down on this is a positive direction. So if I got a positive 5 meters per second squared here, then that says my acceleration is downward. So does that mean that I should have more force upward on this thing, or more force downward? So that's why I would have 2mg minus t. That means this has to be bigger than this to accelerate downward.
I think it's just confusing me because it's going up.
That's correct, but it's accelerating downward. In other words, it's moving upward slower and slower. So I made this as complicated as I could make it.
Okay.
I mean, like I said, it really is. Probably more likely scenario might be that the initial velocity was that way. And if the initial velocity, I like this. Hold on. I like this. Thank you. Let's say this thing gets to somewhere up here, and whatever this number is such where like it now switches directions. If this thing initially wasn't moving down, but was initially moving up, or it switched directions for whatever reason. Maybe this force is greater than this, so it is moving upward, but it's slowing down, and eventually it's going to flip back the other way. So now let's say it's initially moving the opposite direction. So it's not that our frame of reference is changing. This is still true. This going downward, we're still considering positive. But it just happens now, the new situation in purple. That way. So if that's true, what would change about this equation, if anything? Friction is flipped the other direction because it would always oppose motion. So in this particular case, I would subtract that off. So you're right, it's confusing because it's moving that way, but it's accelerating opposite that. Tate and then Jake 2E.
Alright, so like basically it's moving uphill in the positive direction, so as it moves uphill, the 2M is going down, that's why it's positive direction.
Just hypothetical, like have you ever had system basically worked similar to this, where you had the initial going downward, and then it was accelerating in the opposite direction.
What do you mean?
So like right now, in the original system.
So I'm going to get rid of purple, okay?
Yep. We had the velocity going downward. Right?
Correct.
And then we had acceleration, it being pulled upward.
We define it as positive being upward. Technically, I don't necessarily know if that's true or not, right?
Yeah.
Because...
Okay. In a hypothetical in which, like, we knew, like, that the net force was upward, would we then, when it hits zero velocity, like, as it switches over, do we then have to consider static friction if it was...
No, you wouldn't have that.
I know we wouldn't have it, but, like, would it ever, or does it just act like kinetic because it's so brief?
Yeah, so what would happen is at that point, it might come to a stop, right?
Yeah.
Because static friction is greater than kinetic friction. Okay. But I don't think in a problem like this that you would have to think about something like that. And actually, I think in this case, the acceleration is always going to be a positive value, because when I look at these numbers, the maximum sine theta would be 1, the maximum cosine would be 1, and this is obviously only 0.2. So the only way it might be different is if we switch this mass. If this was a 2m, that was only m, and here it'd be 1 minus, and then bigger numbers over here. So that might be an issue then. I'm pretty sure in this case the acceleration really will be that way. Because even if this was hanging vertically down, the acceleration would be that way. So that was a really complicated problem. But I guess the idea of how you might have to solve things in terms of variables and just being careful and starting out like with things first. On your AP for responses, they normally don't start out like that complicated. So I took it from zero to oof pretty quick to do that. But a lot of times they might have you draw a free body diagram first of something. So they might have you draw a free body diagram of this or on this. And then you would need to indicate, for example, the tension here would be the same size arrow as maybe the tension. They might have you do, again, something else with forces or acceleration, but not as complicated, and then they might take it in the end and be pretty complicated. But like I said, and I'll say this because this is going to be on the video one, I did put the sample problem on Google Classroom last night, and the solutions to that was from my test last year. That was one of the problems with it. Now, the solutions are a little bit different at the end because I had to modify the problem at the end. The AP problem has energy on it. We did not test on energy last year. So the one I put on my test, I changed the end of it on. But that's a good example of one. Multiple choice I suggested to, you know, look at maybe your 5 steps to a 5 for the reasonable ones on some of those. And then I did put my notes up for chapter 6 and 7, and I put notes up for sample problems that I did. And I did most of them up here, but there's some other ones. Chapter 6 and 7, and then the discussion with differential equations that I talked about yesterday, I put up there as well with the notes. But again, with that, you might have to think about how would you come up with, say, a terminal velocity, not actually solving a differential equation. We didn't do that. Other questions?
Questions about like how KB students will be able to do?
About what?
Like how KB students?
I don't think so. So like I said, the only thing that I thought would be a little bit new might be that differential equation thing. But that's what we did, what really wasn't the calculus part of it yesterday. And I think you should be able to do power rule pretty well now. I know you've done that for a while. I don't think there's anything with the antiderivatives in there. We will have some of those things before you probably get to them in calc, but I'll give a heads up to it, meaning that essentially it's going to be reverse power rule. It won't be any complicated, like the thing I think Ryan was talking about solving that differential equation yesterday. Mm-hmm. Initially, it might have been a natural log, but it wasn't because it was v squared over that. But yeah, we won't be anything like that. And that's not on tomorrow. Other questions? Look over the last test also, because that is a good resource, I think.
Test corrections, do you remember?
Not test corrections, but homework corrections.
Homework corrections.
corrections. And then the performance rubric I gave you today, Tuesday. Due Tuesday.
And what we have to do with the drag on here? Just
that's okay.
Say again?
What we have to do, what will we have to do with drag?
Drag is basically friction with the air, correct?
Yeah.
So if there is something, it might show up in that form of a differential equation. It could ask you some things about friction with a surface. I mean, drag is basically just a different, like I said, a different form of friction.
Yeah. If there's like the CPA,
That's not a formula even on your formula sheet. So like, I think your group, maybe there was a group in my earlier class that was trying to solve like that coffee filter lab by, I want to say, kind of overthinking it a bit. And in reality, that's not critical because what the AP is going to do is they're going to give you something like KV squared or KV or BV or something like that with a constant that they're saying is the model to use for drag.
That's what we did.
Yeah.
Yeah, we just changed it to alt C.
Yeah, and that's and that's what it would be. It would be something similar, simple with a constant. But you're not expected to know the official form. End up with any food left, John?
No, I didn't.
Happy for you, buddy.
Are you restocking for next week?
I already bought a box. So
good. That's nice. I'm going to give you a little hint that's going to make your life better if you can find it somewhere, but I doubt you can around here. Tried and True Granola Company. It's amazing.
Do you buy in bulk at Sam's
Club?
I had to go up to the Mohican Country Store in Northeast Ohio. I mean, I didn't go up there just for that. Well, I kind of did. But I mean, you know, there are other things up there.
I feel like Amish granola would be really good.
I think this is actually made in Southwest Ohio, but it's just amazing.
Southwest Ohio, I was going to say. They make
granola.
Us, for at our place, we have granola, but it's not ours.
Is there closed yet?
Pickerington, they are. Reynoldsburg, we have been for a while, but Smith's will be open. The produce will be open.
Smith's too. Or Witten's?
Smith's.
Your family?
Yeah. No, it's not. But it's really funny because at Smith's, which is where Regan works, she works in the bakery, the manager's name is Mallory.
Nice.
Isn't that weird?
Whoa. Any other questions on physics before I turn off the video? Do you have socks?
Yes.
So take off a shoe for a minute. What's the point of having socks less than the shoe? Because then you still feel the shoe.
No, because they make your shoes stinky. Yeah,
because
like these shoes, you're not supposed to like.
Why not? Every shoe should be worn with a sock.
I don't wear a sock. I go naked.
They look better without socks. I got a full Rick and Morty collection of shoes.
Really? That's funny.
What's the point of a Rick?